In this video, we are going to create table. For that, first we are going to understand logic, how to create table logic. In this for loop, I equals to 0. So we are going to use this I in our logic, and we are going to create 2's table. So I equals to 0, then R 2 multiply I equals to 0. Why? Because I is 0. Then again I increment by 1, then I equals to 1. Then 2 multiply 1 equals to 2. Why? Because I equals to 1. And same as I equals to 2, then I equals to 2, then 2 multiply 2 equals to 4, and so on up to I equals to 9, because our loop is going to execute up to 10. So array position start with 0, so 0 to 9 equals to 10. So I equals to 9, and 2 9 ja 18. But our 2's table is not complete because 2 10 ja 20, but here 18. So how we are going to complete this? If I am going to add plus 2, then 0 plus 2 equals to 2. Same as 2 plus 2 equals to 4, and 4 plus 2 equals to 6, and up to 9, 18 plus 2 equals to 20. So our logic is going to be create. So what is our logic? So our logic in for loop, we are going to write 2 plus 2 multiply I, that we are going to use in our program. Now we are going to implement our program in Eclipse IDE. So first we are going to declare constant final int array length equals to 10 semicolon. Then we are going to create array int equals to new int in square bracket array underscore length, then semicolon, then we are going to calculate value for each array element. For that we are going to create for loop int I equals to 0 semicolon, then I less than array dot length semicolon I increment, then curly braces. Inside curly braces we are going to write our logic array in square bracket I equals to 2 plus 2 multiply I, then semicolon. Then outside the for loop we are going to write column heading. For that we are going to write system.out.printf, then in double quotes %13 s %n then comma, and in double quotes, 2's table. Then we are going to write